So, yeah, I've been home, I think, a week today. Did I get home Tuesday? I can't remember if I got home Tuesday or Wednesday. I think I got home Tuesday last week. It doesn't feel like I've been home a week. I've been letting my body readjust. I got up, I think I did a live last Wednesday. But I've been letting my body readjust after going through all the different time zones. But there's been something else I've been adjusting to. It's a sense of loss and a sense of near loss. I found when I got home that I couldn't find something that was pretty precious to me, something that I kept about me pretty well every day. And for the life of me, I can't remember whether or not I left it at home, whether I took it away with me, or whether I gave it to my wonderful but sometimes very forgetful husband to put it somewhere safe for me. Anyway, we spent about a week looking for it. And I suddenly realized this morning that I'm in grief, looking for a material object, because last night I had a dear friend that I lost in 2014 come through in a dream to me. And I got up this morning very early again, like 3 o'clock in the morning, started looking around for this stuff, right? And he kept coming back to my mind. So I went and had a look at him on the internet, and I suddenly realized when I was looking at his old Facebook page and his old posts and old messages he sent to me and the conspiratorial stuff we used to share, that he's gone from this material plane. He's still in the spiritual, and he still communicates with me from the spiritual, but loss on the physical causes grief. Loss on the physical is something that we keep looking for. It just like I've been looking for these objects for a week. So I've since 2014 I realized I've still been looking for him. I've still been searching around, still been trying to find him, just like I've searched for these material things for a week. And sure, being psychic, you think, you should be able to just focus. I'm too emotional about it. I can't get a clear being on it. I just keep getting mixed images, and then my logical mind kicks in and goes, but I've looked there. I can't find it there. I've searched there. So it's very different when it's personal. I'm great at finding lost objects for other people. But this, because I want it to be in a particular place, I'm used to it being in a particular place, I'm addictively demanding it be where it should be, and it's gone. I don't know if somebody who came to my house took it, or if I've left it accidentally on the plane, or yeah, but it's been loss. Loss is something that we will all experience on this physical plane, whether it's losing an object, right, and grieving the loss of this object. But it's a huge realization for us to look around our life and go, everybody I love in this life, if I live long enough, I will lose. I will be looking for them at some point for the rest of my existence. And it's this sense of loss and this sense of looking for them that lets us yearn to come back to the physical plane, to play with our psychic peer group again, to play with our friends, our lovers, our children, our mothers, our wives, our family, everybody that we've loved. We come back for them, and we come back to find them, and we come back to play together again. I have so many people come to me for readings and go, is this the one? Is this the relationship? The truth is, every human being will have an infinite number of relationships because we are connected to everybody. Every romantic relationship ends either by somebody leaving or by somebody dying. One person has to die before the other. And when we come back in the next life, our relationships take on a different meaning. They are different roles for us to play. Where we've been the mother in one life, we might be the child in the next. We've been the lover in one, we'll be the parent in the next. Right? Or we'll just be friends. So it's about us coming to term with loss. And I just realized this week that what happens when I'm in loss and in grief is I hide from it. I go back to bed. I stop my spiritual practices. I alternate between searching and hiding. Hiding on the internet, hiding in my work, hiding in bed, hiding staying up late, hiding getting things done, rather than facing it. How many of us hide from our grief? It's made me realize this week that so much of illogical and addictive behaviors are hiding from that grief of loss, whether it's now or in the future. And coming to terms with loss, being able to cope with loss and move forward, because loss and grief can destroy a person faster than just about anything else. So, you know, and it's been surprising to me how down I've been because of my minor loss this week. Yes, spiritual masters shouldn't get down. Newsflash, you know, before enlightenment, chop wood, carry water. After enlightenment, chop wood, carry water. Everybody gets down, and I'm entitled to every human emotion as long as I use it appropriately, and so are you. We're all allowed to get down at different times. We're all allowed to not function as well as what we were hoping we would function. As long as we get back up again. As long as we can go, oh, okay. Right? You know, that's why it's so uplifting when we have friends that were alcoholics and have not touched a drink for a year. They inspire us. Or like my husband, you know, he's been without a cigarette now for 3 months. Good boy. Didn't start until he was 42. Why? Because he was hiding from his loss and his grief. What was he grieving? He was grieving the realization that the active sporting life and the fun and the joy, the life that he'd known, he couldn't do it anymore because of serious injuries. So after being a super athlete, he hid behind his addiction. But everybody does it. So it's not about beating yourself up. When you have an addiction, what you've got to do is have a look at what you're hiding from. What part of grief, what part of loss, what part are you sad about? Coming to terms with that sadness and then moving forward again. This is why people inspire us. Yes, pain needs to be felt, that's so true. And we got to come to terms with that pain. Right? Feel it completely instead of hiding from it. Right? Explore the pain to all of its steps. Right? And then once you've understood that pain, and then the sun rises tomorrow, then you get up and you move forward. And you don't move forward without the pain, and you don't move forward without the loss or the grief. It's just there, but you don't hide from it. I have people come to me after somebody's died and they say, how long will this grief continue? As long as it needs to. And one day you will find that even though the grief is still there, you are enjoying your life and you're allowed to. You're allowed to have the joy back as well. The end of every relationship, even if it was a shitty relationship, will cause you grief. And there will be a sense of loss. But it's about taking that step forward, moving forward. Yes, and I realize that being a good mum, you know, getting up every morning, feeding the kids, looking after them, even when I was in immense pain during that period in my life, was hiding from my grief and from my loss. And it is about being able to function for other people. It is about getting up in the morning and feeding the kids. But it's also about functioning for yourself. And it's also about a return to joy. I know my friends that I've lost, my people that have passed to the other side, would still want me to enjoy myself. The ones that contact me from the other side, I know they still want me to enjoy myself. Every reading I do for anybody that comes to me for mediumship, all their relatives want to tell them the most important thing is they want to tell them to enjoy this life. Get over their pettiness, get over the small things, the things that shouldn't cause us worry, loss and grief. Right? And to listen to some bird song and see the sunrise and find joy in your heart. Yeah. So I know my last couple of lives have been a little bit profound. Last one was about family and how to cope, how to survive your family. Right? But this is how to survive your loss. Right? Not to hide from it. Not to hide from your grief, not to hide from your pain, but just to let it become part of you, part of your overall experience of life. If you shut it down and forget about it, you've lost that wonderful experience. It becomes subconscious. It's still there. But if you feel it fully, you can cope. You can move forward with joy. Feed them. So, my love, so if you do lose something, remember the joy of it gave you while it was with you. And if you lose a relationship, remember the joy, the good times that you had. All right? And remember all the good things about it. Everything that was good. All right? Because that's the fastest way to find something again. If you've lost something around the house, don't go, oh, this, terrible, terrible, terrible. Think about how wonderful it is, how good it made you feel. All right? And that's the quickest way to find it. If you've lost somebody to death, right, think about how good they made you feel. Give them plenty of joy on the other side. Let them see that you're joyful. And you know what? They reincarnate quickly if you give them joy. And if they reincarnate quickly, you get to hold them again in this life. Just like the lost thing that you can find. You know, if you've lost a person, they can come back as a little baby that you will hold again. Right? And if you love somebody that much, it doesn't matter what form they come back in. Right? You just enjoy that love.